Hi, Internet. Welcome to the Gradtron YouTube channel. It is Thin Lizzy Thursday, and the lighting is terrible today, so apologies about that. But today, we're doing the audience vote, and the audience voted for She Knows. You know, the audience vote, I always... You know, I have mixed feelings on the audience vote, because one way, you know, it allows you guys to be more interactive and give you guys a bit more of a say in the channel. But on the other hand, it's always like, whatever is the most popular song wins. Like, not necessarily the most interesting song, but like... You know, if there's, like, one song that's a single, that's the one that always wins the poll. So I have, like, mixed feelings on this. We're like, okay, we have, like, B-sides and demos and rarities and Black Star Riders. And, like, oh, and then the song from The Greatest Hits wins. So it's like, I don't know. I wonder about the validity of the polls. Not that it's, not that I'm questioning the integrity of the election necessarily. And not like that. But I'm saying that I wonder about, like, how useful is it? You know, if we should just go back to the random thing every week, or if you guys like the poll, let me know in the comments. But this song is, She Knows, off of Nightlife, and this is a Thin Lizzy song that I think is solid, I think it's good. I don't necessarily think it's greatest hits material, though. I think there's so many other great songs in the catalog, I wondered why this one was singled out on the greatest hits CD. So, like, when I'm listening to Dedication, the tracks from Nightlife are a bit of a momentum killer. So, like, I would keep Still in Love with You on the greatest hits, but, like, as far as Showdown and She Knows, I would maybe trade She Knows for Thunder and Lightning if I'm doing a greatest hits CD. If I'm doing a one-disc CD, this is one I might drop. But it's still good, and I want to see, you know, how we feel about it, putting it under the microscope. So let's check out She Knows by Thin Lizzy.
When you see it, Mother Mary, I need you quick. She knows, and she gives her everything. She knows, and she can do a thing. She knows, and she tries her best. She knows.
So I'm definitely looking forward to Dream Sketcher saying that the drumming is frantic on this track and that there's too much going on when it's really, like, so mellow and laid back. I am looking forward to that. I think drumming with, like, swing elements in rock music, I think is just maybe not her speed. I think she, like, if it's going to be rock, it's more got to be, like, four on the floor, like, on the grid kind of thing. And this is, you know, definitely not that. Like, Brian Downey, you know, one of the great things about him as a drummer is he has some swing. So, I mean, musically, it's very, it's mellow, it's laid back. The vocal from Phil is very pretty, and it's got a nice groove to it. This is a nice, chill, classic rock song, where it almost, like, it's not quite soft rock because the guitars are too heavy, but, like, Ron Nevison definitely, like, you know, dialed the band back a few notches to just make it a more chill kind of track. And, I mean, it sounds very pleasant. It does have a nice groove to it. And, you know, very good utilization of the two guitars, where you've got, like, a more bouncy, jangly guitar, and then you've got the, you know, the held-out power chord. So, I mean, it's they're utilizing the two guitars well. Great groove from the rhythm section. All around pleasant.
Who's got the junk when you're feeling low down? Who's gonna heal when there's none to go around? Who's gonna help you when you feel you've had enough? Cheers.
All right, so once again, great vocal from Phil. Looking at the lyrics, I never realized there was a very subtle line, just a slide guitar injection. I had never really noticed that when listening to the song all the years of hearing the song, that little vocal affectation. Just it completely went under the radar for me, kind of buried in the mix. The solo, I realized, is one of the less memorable ones in the Lizzy catalog, at least for me. The latter half of the solo, I remember very well, but the first half, I'm like, I don't remember this at all, despite having listened to the song so much over the years. And so I wonder, you know, if that is a testament to just it being a weaker solo, in the sense that, like, there are certain Lizzy songs where I maybe listen to them less. They're not as much in the rotation, but I still, like, can sort of hum the solo. This is one where, you know, I heard the solo, I'm like, this, it just wasn't ringing a bell, and I was actually genuinely surprised. So I wonder how much of the song kind of just becomes background for me as it continues to go on. Like, it doesn't grab me as much as a listener. Like, it still grabs me, but I think, like, once we get into the solo section, I do maybe tend to zone out most of the time when I listen to it, just because it is so chill. And then lyrically, I don't really know what the song is necessarily about. I mean, Mother Mary, that's obviously going to be a, you know, a Catholicism thing, but, you know, who's got the funk when you're feeling all down? Who's going to love you when there's no one around? Who's going to help you, especially when you're sick? Mother Mary, I need you quick. She knows, and she gives her everything she knows, but she can't do a thing. She knows, and she tries her best. She knows. So, like, is that just, like, the best you can hope for is, like, praying to Mary as a Catholic? Like, when you're, you know, in a bad spot, at least you can always pray. Is that the meaning of the lyric? If you think you know the meaning of the lyric, let me know in the comments below. But, yeah, let's get back to it. Sorry about the pause there. I had to take care of something quick. All right, back to the song.
Who's got the stuff when you're feeling low down? Who's gonna help you when there's no one else around? Who's gonna love you, especially when you're ill? Mother Mary, I hope you will. She knows that she gives her everything. She knows.
Great guitar part there. That ending lick sounded very Gary Moore-esque. So I wonder if this is one of the ones where they probably demoed it when Gary was still in the band, and they just had to leave in some of his leads, because that definitely didn't feel like the kind of lead that Robbo or Scott would write. That definitely feels like them playing a lead that Gary came up with. Like, I'm almost certain that had to be, like, a Gary Moore... that's a Gary Moore lick. Like, I feel pretty confident in that. I don't even need to look that up. So, yeah, She Knows. I mean, it's a good song. I don't think it's a bad song. I think the solo is, like, slightly less memorable than other Lizzy solos. Doesn't mean it's a bad solo. It's still, like, this is a very good, competent, classic rock song. And it is the kind of thing that it would be pleasant to hear on the radio, pleasant to hear on an album. At a live show, maybe it's a bit too mellow, but, I mean, it's still a cool tune. I know it sounds like I hate this and I'm harsh on it, but I just think it's, like, maybe a tad overrated to appear on the greatest hits over other songs, but I don't think it's, like, it's not like it's unreasonable to be on a greatest hit CD. Yeah, I would say it's not unreasonable to be on a greatest hit CD, but I would place other tracks above it. And so now comes the part where we rank it. I have no idea where this is gonna go. Is the trick? So I Michael says I'm just random and that I just pick a random song when I'm doing these rankings. And that, like, there's no rhyme or reason. But basically what I do is I look at a song that I feel kind of similar about, like, just a gut feeling, and then I decide which I like better. Like, that's how I do it. So, for example, if I look at this, and I think about Romeo and the Lonely Girl, I'm like, that's not even close. So I don't even bother looking in, like, triple S. I try to find a song that is more appropriate. So I'm like, is it close to Angel of Death? Is it closer to She Cries? You know, where does this end up? Let's see here. All right, so Solo Down in Soho, I like more. But I think I like it more than Half Cast. So this is where it ends up. All right, so I'm definitely curious. I know that it's one of the most beloved Lizzy songs, so I'm probably going to be, you know, more lukewarm on it than a lot of people in the comments. Definitely curious to see how you guys feel about the song in the comments below. I'm sure there's going to be some anger and vitriol thrown my way. But, you know, while it's on my mind, I'm going to play another song with some swing on the drums. And this is mainly for Dreamcatcher. Dreamcatcher, what do you think about this kind of drumming? I'm sure she knows the song, or maybe she doesn't. So another song with some swing on the drums. Yeah, so curious to see if the swing of the drums is the issue, or maybe, like, Brian pushes a little bit too much and adds too many accents. So definitely, you know, let me know what you think of that, Dreamcatcher. And also, you know, in the comments, any fans of Strutter? All right, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, everyone.